Cisco SD-WAN topology has a full mesh topology by default. In other words, all sites can communicate with each other without any limitation. In this section, two other topologies, hub and spoke, and mesh topologies implemented in Cisco SD-WAN infrastructure. Just to remind you, we have two types of policy in Cisco SD-WAN infrastructure. Localized policy that are applied directly to WAN routers, and centralized policy that are applied to VSmart controller. For topology change, centralized policy is used in Cisco SD-WAN infrastructure. In other words, every topology change is implemented through VSmart controller. VSmart controller can change the topology easily with filtering routes when advertising through OMP routing protocol or changing preference attribute. What is interesting to me when I implement different topologies in Cisco SD-WAN infrastructure is that topology can be implemented per VPN service. In other words, you can, for example, implement a hub and spoke topology for data traffic, but at the same time implement a full mesh topology for voice traffic. It is not easy at all to implement such a topology in traditional solutions. Hub and spoke topology is the first topology that we implement. Site 1 with site ID 101 is our hub site, and other sites with site ID from 102 to 104 are spoke sites. Before we change the topology, let's make sure what the current topology is. We connect to site 4 WAN router and then check routing table with command show IP route VRF 10. As you can see, we have got the routes for all sites, but the next hop address points to the system IP of destination itself. So it means that we have a direct connection with different sites. We can also check the connectivity with trace route command, trace route, VRF 10 172 16.3, for example, site 3 with source site 4. As you can see, direct connection between site 4 and site 3 exists. Since we have two transport between sites, internet and MPLS, the question is which transport is used to route traffic between sites. With command show SD-WAN OMP route, we can check OMP routing table with further details. For example, if we check the detail for site 3, which is 172.16.3, site 1, site 2, and site 3, you can see that there are two paths with two TLACs over MPLS IPsec and over Internet IPsec. Both have no preference or the same preference. So we can expect that the traffic will be shared between these two WAN transport. To make sure, we can also check with another command, show SD-WAN IP FIB VPN 10. As you can see, there are four paths to reach destination site 3 or 172.16.3, two over public internet and two over MPLS. From MPLS transport to internet, from internet to internet, from MPLS to MPLS, and finally from internet to MPLS transport. So, as we have expected, traffic is load shared between different when transfer. Now we can start changing topology for VPN 10 service traffic. However, this is the only VPN service that we have implemented in our topology, but it is important to know that topology changes are possible per service VPN. Topology change are configured through a centralized policy. In other words, all configurations are implemented in VSmart controller. When VSmart controller learns or advertises routes through OMP routing protocol, it can control which routes to which sites are advertised with which preferences. First, let's specify to VManage which site is our hub site and which sites are our spoke sites. In custom option, in the list, in the site, this is the list of hub site. We have only one hub site with site ID 101. And this is the list of our spoke sites. We have got three sites with site ID from 102 to 104. Then we have to specify service VPN number in which we change the topology. We have got only one VPN service, VPN 10 with the ID 10. Now we specify our interesting topology in the topology section. In a topology, hub and spoke with a name, hub and spoke. Copy also for description. For VPN 10, the hub site is the site with the name of hub. Add. And then spoke sites are the sites with the name of spokes that we have already configured. Now we have to specify a container policy. As in the previous section explained, container policy is just a container for policies of many types. Container policies require, since it is the only policy that can be applied to VSmart controller, we create a new one. Next, in the topology section, at topology, import hub and spoke topology, import with the name of VSmart policy. Since this policy must be applied to VSmart controller, then we can preview the commands. As we can see in the output command, the policy is applied only when routes are advertised to spokes through VSmart controller. The policy itself says that routes will only be advertised to spoke routers if they belong to the hub site and VPN 10 service. This is also true for TLOC routes. TLOC routes are only advertised to spoke site if they belong to hub site. The other routes are rejected by default. With this policy, spoke sites cannot communicate to each other, and the communication only with hub site is only possible. Let's activate it. Again, we can check VRF10 routing table in site 4 WAN router with show IP route VRF10 command. As we expect, there is no more any route in CH4 except the routes belonging to hub site. And there is no route belonging to site 2 or site 3. Also, we can check it with trace route command. VRF10, site 1, with the source, site 4, But there is no connection with site 2, for example. Still, there are two questions in this topology. First, how can I prefer MPLS transport to internet transport for the communication between sites? Second, how spoke sites can communicate to each other, but only through hub site and not directly, since our topology is hub and spoke. To answer these two questions, let's edit our policy. First, we need to differentiate between MPLS and internet transport by setting TLOC preference. We set preference 200 for MPLS TLOC and preference 150 for internet TLOC. TLOC underline hop 111 for hop over MPLS, IPsec preference 200, the same IP 111 101 over public internet encapsulation IPsec, and with a lower priority 150, and then save. Then we apply the new preference in our hub and spoke policy or topology. In hub and spoke, edit, here manage custom preference and prefix list. By default, all hubs are equal and all spoke sites connect to all hub, and there is no connection between spoke sites. But now we advertise hub TLOC that we have already configured. Save, activate the new policy, and preview new configuration. This is our preference for MPLS and internet, and this is our new policy. In sequence 10, routes belonging to hub site and VPN 10 service will be advertised to spoke routers, but sequence 20 is new policy. The spoke routes are not rejected anymore, but they are advertised with the TLOC hub with our preferences. And only TLOC routes belonging to the hub site will be advertised, and the other routes or TLOC routes will be rejected. And then configure. Again, we show IP route VRF10 command. In CH4, we can check what is the new changes in routing table. Show IP route VRF10. Now we expect that we can connect to the other sites, to other spoke sites, but only through the hub site. As you can see, we have the all routes belonging to different sites, but the next hub address point to system IP of hub, and the communication only through the hub site is possible. Just to make sure, we can trace site, for example, 2 in VRF10 with source 41. As you can see, the communication is established but through hub site. We can also check it with show SD-WAN OMP route. For site 3, for example, As you see, we have got MPLS route with preference 200 and internet route, but with preference 150. Which route is installed in routing table? We can check it with show SD-WAN, IP, FIB, VPN 10. As you can see, for site 3, only MPLS routes are installed in the routing table, and the traffic will be forwarded only through the MPLS. You can also see in the trace route output 192.168.2.2 is the IP of MPLS transport. In the next scenario, we implement a mesh topology. In this new topology, site 1 and site 2 will be in the same region, region 1. Site 3 and site 4 will be in another region, region 2. Only sites in the same region can communicate to each other, and there is no communication between sites in different regions. To implement it, first we have to define our regions and specify which sites belong to which region. In the list, in the site, we create two new lists, region 1 for site 1 and site 2. And region 2 for site 3 to site 4. And now we configure our new topology, a topology, mesh topology, with the name of mesh 1 for VPN 10. Our first region is region 1 with the site configured in region 1, and the new region, region 2, with the site configured in region 2. Save. The new topology is configured, and in the container policy we have to detach the previous topology and attach the new topology. Edit, in the topology, detach the previous topology and import the new mesh topology. And preview the command. As you see, we have got two policy. The moment region 1 and region 2, and the communication only between sites in the same region is possible, since the routes are advertised only to the spokes that belong in the same region, otherwise they are rejected. Activate. Now again, show IP route VRF 10. We expect that site 4 can connect site 3 only. As you can see, the communication with site 3 is only possible with trace route VRF 10, site 3 with source site 4. It is possible. And the communication is direct, and it is not possible to connect to site 2. So we have implemented two topologies in this section.